Dear students, online classes by Mother Rouse India Public School is a good source for not to have any obstruction in the learning process of the students. With this, I, Gurvinder Kaur, is again here in front of you all with my next class. In this video, I am going to tell you about the question answers of the same chapter, which is in continuation with the part 1 of the chapter. Name of chapter is Nelson Mandela of Grade 10 Subject is English Literature. So students, here are the question answers of chapter Nelson Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. Chapter number 2, class 10th. Question number 1. Why did such a large number of international leaders attend the inauguration? What did it signify the triumph of? Triumph is victory. Answer. The inauguration ceremony was attended by politicians and dignitaries from more than 140 countries. Such a large number of international leaders attended the inauguration to mark the occasion of installation of South Africa's first democratic non-racial government. Memorable. In South Africa, this was for the first time that non-racial government was installed or formed. Now, part 2 of this question number 1, that is, what did it signify the triumph of? Answer, it signified the triumph of justice, peace and human dignity. Question number 2, what does Mandela mean when he says he is simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before him? Answer is, Nelson Mandela does not forget the selfless struggles and sacrifices of the black heroes. Again, I am telling you, black heroes, he calls to the people who had actually sacrificed their lives for the struggle of freedom against the regime of apartheid in South Africa. He says that their sufferings and sacrifices can never be counted or repaid. So, when he says he is simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before him, he means that he has learned a lot from them and adopted all the essential, that is important, qualities from them to fight against the racial government in South Africa. Question number 3. Would you agree that the depths of oppression create heights of character? How does Mandela illustrate this? Can you add your own examples to this argument? It's an important point also in the chapter. See the answer. And yes, we agree with the point of view of Mandela. He illustrates this by saying that decades of oppression, I hope students you all know, one decade is equal to 10 years. So it's decades, means for many, many years of oppression and brutality. Means whites over there in South Africa, they were very brutal to the blacks. In South Africa had the effect of producing extraordinary leaders like Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisler, Bram Fischer and Robert Solbiquis. He says that their kind of courage, means the way they were courageous, their kind of courage, wisdom and generosity will never be seen in future. He also says that apartheid regime could not extinguish the flame of freedom in the blacks. There was, now it's a second part of that same question. Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose, etc. also achieved heights of character by facing depths of oppression. These are all the freedom fighters of India. Now, question number 4. How did Mandela's understanding of freedom change with age and experience? Answer is, as a young boy, freedom for Mandela meant to be able to run in the fields near his mother's hut, to be able to swim in the clear stream running through his village.
Then as a student, when he grew up a little, as a student, freedom for him meant to be able to stay out at night, read what he pleased, and to go where he chose. Then when he became a young man, as a young man, he yearned for the basic and honorable freedoms of achieving his potential, of earning his keep, of marrying and having a family. Still later in life, means what else he wanted more when he became little more older, still later in life, he wanted the freedom of all his countrymen. Now the next question, number 5. How did Mandela's hunger for freedom change his life? Answer is, it was Mandela's hunger for the freedom of his people. His people here refers to the blacks in South Africa, to live their lives with dignity and self-respect. That animated his life, means his life was also the same. Now this hunger changed a fearful young man. Fearful young man here was Nelson Mandela, who is changed into a bold one. This changed a family-loving husband into a man without home. This forced a life-loving man to live like a monk. It was all due to the hunger for freedom. Now question number 6. How does Mandela describe the system of government in his country? It is divided into two parts, that in the first decade and in the final decade of the 20th century. Answer, according to Mandela, the system of government in the first decade of 20th century was based on erecting a system of racial domination against the dark-skinned people. Dark-skinned people means blacks in South Africa of their own land. Own land, South Africa. Now, in the last decade, what happened? In the last decade of 20th century, that system had been overturned. It was just removed, and in place of a racial government, a democratic government had been established. Means in the first decade, there was racial government, and in the last decade it was overturned and non-racial government was established.
So students, here is the end of chapter number 2. In next video we will start with next chapter, and that would be chapter number 1 of your another book supplementary reader, Footprints Without Feet. Till then, be happy, don't panic, be careful, be safe. Be a warrior. We will fight together and win. Keep supporting government. Thank you.